guys, it's Nicole and Albert here from Relax My Dog. We're here every week answering all of your doggy related questions. On last week's video, we asked you what you would like to see in this week's video, and the answer has come back as a dog flea shampoo. Now, as a little take on this, I'm actually going to make a dog flea spray. So this is something that you can spray on your dog as much as you need to. It's really useful for before walks, before socialisation classes, anywhere where your dog is going to come into contact with plants or other animals. So all you need for today's video is just a spray bottle like this that you can fill up with your mixture, a large lemon and some water. Now, homemade flea spray does not kill fleas on contact. It's really important to remember this. It doesn't work like a pesticide. It's best used alongside a lot of other natural flea control methods, such as washing your dog's bedding frequently, wash rugs where your pet likes to spend time, vacuuming every day. A flea comb is a really good and valuable tool as well, and you can also comb this mixture into your dog's fur as an even better precaution to fleas. You can also use, rather than a lemon, you can swap this for the apple cider vinegar, but as we used that for the last shampoo recipe, I thought I'd go with the lemon one for this time. Okay, so you just need to bring a pint of water to the boil. Okay, so we just want to cut it into quite small slices like this, but make sure that you leave the lemon rind on because that is going to have the best properties in it for our flea treatment. Now, there are different oils that you can use as well to add to this recipe, but it's always recommended that only really experienced pet owners will use these because you have to use different amounts of these herbs and oils for different ailments. So I wouldn't recommend adding to it. It is sometimes nice to get a little bit of extra scent. So you can use things like a lavender oil and things. And it does give the spray a really nice scent, but just to keep it simple, I just recommend going for the lemon smell because it's a really nice fresh smell anyway on your pet. Okay, so once you've brought your water to the boil, I just want you to place your slices of lemon in the water, and then we're going to switch off the heat and leave it to steep with a cover on it overnight. So you ideally about 24 hours, but if you can't leave it for 24 hours, then 12 will do. Okay, so once you've left your mixture to sit for between 12 and 24 hours, just transfer it over into a pint glass. You should be left with something that looks like this. And then it just goes straight into your dispenser bottle. I've obviously done this very messily. So Albie's all ready for his flea spray. Aren't you, Alb? So now it's really important when you're spraying this to make sure that you don't spray it on your dog's face. To put it on the back of his neck, sometimes you can just, if you just dab a sponge inside your mixture and just dab it on the back of his neck, and that just means that you definitely won't get anything in his eyes, because obviously if you get lemon water in your eyes, it's not going to be very nice, is it, Albert? But because Albert's small, I'm just going to cover him like this and then just spray just a light mist over him. And he'll have a good shake now, won't ya? Oh, big stretch, Albie. Big stretch. That's it, shake it off. And there you have it. That is your flea prevention spray. Good boy, Alb. Good boy. You smell lemony now. We really hope that today's video has been interesting for you. Let us know how you find your flea sprays and let us know how good your dog smells when they've got lemony scent on them. If you did enjoy today's video, please do remember to give us a big thumbs up. Now we've got another poll on this week and it's again asking you guys what you want to see in next week's video. So please do remember to vote on that so that you get your say on what we make next week. As you can see, Albert's a very tired boy today. So I'm going to go off and put him to bed now. So we'll see you again next week. Bye!
Hi there, it's Nicole and Albert here from Relax My Dog. We're here every week answering all of your doggy related questions. On last week's vlog, we had a poll on which video you would like to see this week. And the winner was how to make a DIY dog toy. Now this dog toy is the easiest thing that you'll ever make and it will keep your pup occupied for hours. Okay, so today's easy sock and bottle toy for dogs is a really simple and cost-effective way of keeping your dog occupied.